Wireless providers, industry experts, and the federal government all say that scam texts are going through the roof right now. I can attest, I got them too.
Yeah, and everything about them is annoying, including the name for them, which we'll get into in a second. But first, I know what you might be thinking here. Phishing scams on cell phones and email are nothing new. You also probably know that if you see something suspicious, you should not click on any links and never give your personal information. That is all accurate, of course, but there is a reason why this old tactic keeps gaining steam.
If you've been getting more texts announcing bogus deliveries, giveaways, or just about anything else recently, you're likely a target of SMS phishing, also called
smishing. Is that a word that you actually use?
Yes, it is a word, and yes, I have used it. I'm getting a lot of phone calls asking me about this.
Mark Lanterman, Chief Technology Officer of Computer Forensic Services, has been talking about phishing texts for years, but they have exploded in the last two. The Federal Trade Commission says $86 million was reported lost in the U.S. in 2020 from frauds originating in scam texts. And according to a 2021 scam report from the app RoboKiller, scam texts jumped 58% last year, surpassing scam calls by more than 15 billion, with a B.
Certain types of attacks occur in waves. In the hacker community, someone will say, hey, this is what I'm doing and it's working. So then everyone else tries it too.
If you want it to stop, the FTC says you can file a formal federal complaint. If that sounds like too much work, report it to your wireless provider by forwarding the message to the number 7726, which spells spam. Or, easiest of all, just click on the number and, depending on your phone, find the option to block the caller.
It won't eliminate it, but it'll be less of a headache for you.
That brings us to the newest headache. In recent days, reports are spiking of smishing attempts coming from people's own cell phone numbers.
All that is a way that hackers try to get you to click on something or trust something, because you're not going to block your own number. If I were to send a message to you as you, I know I'm going to get your attention. And now my message just has to trick you into doing something for me.
If you do get tricked into offering sensitive information, experts say you should contact your wireless provider ASAP and file a report on identitytheft.gov.
Can you get in trouble just by clicking a link?
Normally, what we see is you have to interact a little bit more with that click on a cell phone. You know, clicking on a link on a computer, that's a different problem. Clicking on a link in a text message or email on your phone, you tend to not have the same level of risk.
But Mark says it's still a good idea to be extra careful and avoid opening anything you can't verify.
I hate to quote a corny TV show, but we are the weakest link. It's easier for me to hack a person to trick you into giving me what I want than it is for me to hack your technology.
Well, Verizon and other wireless providers have said they are aware of the recent surge in smishing attempts that appear to be coming from a user's own cell phone number, and they are working on something about that. In the meantime, Mark says it's worth trying to block your own number, as weird as it sounds. He said it worked for him without any issues. That wasn't the case, though, for some of his friends and families, Jana. So you just got to kind of give it a whirl.
I've been smushed, I've been smished, and now I have to block myself. This is amazing. Thank you so much, Kent. Yeah.